so before you program a Half-Life mod, you need to do a few things. Choose an SDK, create a mod folder, and have all the necessary tools ready. Let's start with the SDK first, short for Software Development Kit. Typically, an SDK contains a bunch of tools and asset sources and maybe source code to build game DLLs. Obviously, we're interested in the SDKs that have code. If you do some searching, you're gonna find the following code bases, and let's go through them one by one. SDK 2.3 is pretty old. Only use it if you wish to support one Half-Life. You're gonna need Visual Studio 6.0 for it, so I don't really recommend this one. SDK 2.4 is the official, latest official one, and you can compile it on VS2010. However, beware, if you're on Linux, the make files need updating. You can freely use this one if you can't use the latest Visual Studio. It's good enough, it's official, although I wouldn't recommend it. It still has some bugs which are interestingly fixed in the latest Steam version. Really makes me wonder why Valve doesn't just provide the same code in the SDKs as in their games. Oh well. Half-Life updated SDK is my personal recommendation for everybody. Linux makefiles are updated, the code is updated to compile on the latest tools, and some of the C code is converted to C++. I'm gonna be using this one in the tutorials. If you need some Opposing Force stuff, the Opposing Force updated SDK is also pretty good. It has all of the weapons, almost all of the NPCs, it has ropes, especially ropes. And so on. As for the rest, I'm going to talk about them in another video, but for now, Half-Life Unified SDK is basically Half-Life, Opposing Force, and BlueShift all in one SDK, hence Unified. And I wouldn't recommend this for beginners, it's more for experienced, especially like programmer types. So if you're not like a hardcore programmer, you're gonna have a hard time, because this thing uses CMake and VC package, and CMake is like this build system thingy. VC package manages external dependencies. If you don't know what those are, just steer away for now, because I don't want you banging your head against the wall right at the start. Not yet, at least. So we're gonna cover the Unified SDK later on. Not now. There's also a bunch of other community SDKs, like the Featureful SDK, Trinity, Spirindi, my own SDK, Half-Life ADM, Spirit of Half-Life and its 20 different versions, and I'll be listing those in another video, once again. The trouble is that some of these don't work with the 25th anniversary update, which initially screwed up many SDKs, but things are mostly fine now, it's been like patched away. Now, you can find the Half-Life Update SDK on GitHub, and if you don't know how to use Git, download it as a zip file. If you do, well, what are you doing? Just use Git clone and then, you know, the URL to the repository. It's super easy. If you're still using the zip thingy, well, just extract it into any folder, preferably a path without any spaces in it. Preferably. Now, let's make a mod folder. So, chances are you already know this, but I'm gonna cover it anyway. So, a mod is really just a folder in a Half-Life directory with some special text files in it. That's all. At least that's a bare-bones mod. Here is the folder structure of a typical Half-Life mod. So, what you're gonna do is go to your Half-Life installation folder in, you know, Steam, Steam Apps Common, and create a new folder. Then you're gonna go to the Valve folder and copy a file called liblist.gam. It's a simple text file that contains basic info about a mod, so it can show up on Steam. After you paste it in the mod folder, you can open it up in Notepad or any text editor, really. For starters, edit the title. You can restart Steam and your mod should show up. Now, let's prepare the tools. I'll be using Visual Studio 2022. If you happen to be watching in the year 2025 or 6, chances are a new Visual Studio is out, so use that instead. Eventually there's gonna be a video about setting this up on Linux too, but it might take a while because I got other things to do right now. But anyway, you're gonna need to create a Microsoft account because it's gonna ask you to quote-unquote activate Visual Studio about a month after you install it. No worries though, it's all free. During the installation, you only need the C++ desktop development kit. Nothing else. Like, that's all you need. The game dev stuff that's gonna download Unity and Unreal, you don't really need that. So just, you know, aim for the C++ desktop development kit. So once all of that is done and installed, navigate to where you extracted the SDK. Then you're gonna go to Projects, Visual Studio 2019, and open up projects.sln. It's going to ask you if you want to upgrade the solution to VS 2022, that is MSVC 142, that's its compiler. And yes, you should absolutely do that, so it can actually build. Here you see a couple of projects, and I'm going to quickly describe each of them. So CDLL is the client DLL. It contains the HUD code, view bobbing code, some weapon prediction code, a little bit of rendering, and other client-side stuff. HLDLL is the game DLL, the server DLL, if you will. It contains the monsters, triggers, player code, and so on. For most of the series, we're going to focus on this one. Client stuff only arrives in Chapter 6, although we do touch upon it a teeny tiny bit in Chapter 4 as part of the weapon programming stuff. Anyway, control-click both projects, right-click, and hit Build. This might take a few minutes. Once it's done, you might see an error message at the end, assuming you're using the updated SDK. It says it basically cannot copy the DLLs into the mod folder. Thing is, updated SDK has a filecopy.bat file, which is currently configured to output to the Half-Life updated mod folder. You don't have that, probably. You can just open up with Notepad and change it to your mod folder. It's that easy. Now build the projects again, and it should work now. Now, I do want you to notice a couple of things. If you want your mod to have custom code, it absolutely needs to have a CLDLLs and a DLLs folder. If you look at liblist.gam, you'll see it also specifies a path to the game DLL, but not to the client DLL. That's kind of funny to me. Anyway, I just want you to get used to this folder structure. Look how other mods do it. For example, download, I don't know, any mod that you know of, Poke646 comes to mind. Or just look at Counter-Strike, look at Valve, just, you know, analyze how things are structured, and soon you're gonna get the big picture. Now for the end, let's actually make a change. Let's make all zombies emit light and print ouch when they're hit. So go to source files, drop down DLLs, and find zombie.cpp. Now find the CZombie class and find its spawn method, then add this line of code. It doesn't matter what it does, you're gonna find out. Now scroll down to take damage and write this right here. This is the Half-Life equivalent of printing. If your mod is currently running, make sure to exit, because we're gonna compile the DLL now and you can't overwrite DLLs while they're being used. So build the project now, and you should see that the new DLLs are there. You know, look at the timestamp, that's how you can tell. And now you can, you know, run the mod, launch a test map that you might have built, or load a Half-Life map, and you'll see what you've achieved. Don't forget to enable developer mode in the console so you can actually see the messages. Now, if you're just a programmer, like you don't do anything else, all you do is write code, I think you're gonna have a hard time with Half-Life modding, because a lot of this stuff that you actually do in Half-Life needs to tie into mapping somehow, into level design. Chapter 2 and 3, we're gonna be making map entities, basically triggers and such. And so many of the fundamentals are in there. I would highly advise you to get acquainted with mapping, basically, you know. So if you don't know mapping, I am soon going to be working on a mapping tutorial series. However, in the meantime, you can always visit the whole Half-Life, visit my own server for help, or watch Dimbeek's mapping series or any of the other ones. There's lots of nice stuff out there, you know, just, you know, get in there and, you know, digest some of that content. Set up Jack, set up Drench Broom or whatever, and start making some rooms. Also, another thing, some of the videos in this series are pretty outdated, so if you encounter errors while following them, like compile errors, just don't worry. Look at the comments, or if your solution isn't there, write one. If your problem isn't there, write one. And we're gonna come up with a solution, don't worry. Also, I'm gonna be making these catch-up videos from time to time, so if there's a major SDK change, I'm gonna make a video, and then I'm gonna write about it in the pinned comment in the affected videos, so you can know what's going on. Anyway, in the next part, we're gonna make a completely new entity from scratch. Until then, happy programming.